All right, here we go. This is going to be Operation Saturn of Global War 1936, version 4.1. We are on the Russian and CCP turn number 8. So while, yes, cavalry is no longer available and I could be buying heavy stuff, I will not because I have a fire sale. Couple of housekeeping things. First off, since Germany declared war on Russia, all of Mongolia aligns and Tuva, whatever that is. I clean this up and I get that to the correct color. Other than that, I think the rest of it looks fine. There is one piece of housekeeping that has to be done, and that is this this KMT infantry here needs to roll because he still has his retreat, and he came from Hunan, so we'll roll for him. And it's an 8, so he is fine. Okay, so CCP next. CCP is going to spend $6 on 2 cavalry, so they're going to save 1. Then they are going to... a couple of attacks. First off is the cavalry off of this is going to go here to Hunan, and he'll be joined by 1 infantry. Secondly is that this entire army will march 1 space to the north. I'm assuming that I'm going to win that, so let me just go ahead and throw that on. He'll be joined by these 2 infantry from here. He'll also be joined by these 2 infantry from Singhai. And then, what else? Oh, geez, my thing is doing the weird jumping back and forth. Then I'm going to go in here with 1, 2, 3, 4 cavalry. So 1 is crossing the river. Or sorry, 1 is. So what these are going to do is these, because they can move 2 from Shensi, they're going to go 1 to Suyan and then 2 into Hopei. That means they can go around the river penalty. So they'll, and then the 1 coming from this direction obviously is no river penalty. So that's only, they'll all shoot at 3s. So you can draw the line straight here and the river's not there. This cavalry will go into this one here. With those. So I get 3 3s there and a bunch of 1s. I think that's it for attacks. All that I can think of. Okay, so let's roll over here. We got it. This one does have to cross a river, so we got a 2 and a 1 versus a 2. So let's see. We'll do the 2 in red and the 1 in black. Nothing. And then his 2. We'll grab this teal one. Went by the 2. Okay, so now we're at a 3 and a 2 versus a 2. So the 3 in red, 2 in black, and his 2 in teal. Got him with a 1. And if he were to retreat, it'd be bad, but he didn't retreat, so he's defending, not attacking. Let's see. good. And then this attack up here. So I've got 4 at 2. Oh, sorry, 3 versus 2 at 2 and 1 at 3. So we'll see if we can. So I got 4 at 3 in red, 2 at 2 in blue, and 1 at 4 in black. That is one hit on his part. Okay. Get rid of a red die. And I guess just made the odds not as good. That's one hit for me and none for him. So he loses the cavalry. Getting the odds a little better. That is, 2 hits for him and none for me. So that's not good. So we will have to retreat. And we will retreat. We need to go this way because I came through that direction. Okay. That's not as good. And then down here, we've got, we'll try R3 at, 2 for 2 mountains and a cavalry. Try those first. And nothing. Good thing I don't have attack weaknesses. And then I have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times 2 is 12. So 12 at 1. Theoretically, I should be able to. By statistics, I should get 1. I'm going to roll 6 to start. Nothing. Roll it again. And there's my 1. Then we'll roll his 2 here in the teal. Oh, no, it's a 4. And he got it with a 4. We're going to go ahead and take the cavalry. That's fine. Just sad about that, though. Get rid of some dice because we don't need that many. And all right, now I am going to spend my 1 remaining IPP. Let me go ahead and grab these while I'm up here. They're going to get placed. Let me just set them over here for now. Spend my 1 remaining IPP, and which one do I want more? I'm going to roll for Quang Tung. So that's 1, 2, 3. On a roll of 3 or less, I can align Quang Tung. Just don't roll a 12. That's an 8. That's a fail. Okay. And these two are going to go into... they can go up here. Now I'm at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So a roll of 8 or less and I get an infantry. And that's a 9. I miss. Oh my gosh, the dice don't like me this turn. Bummer. Okay. So let's, from there, so I just need to change this to, so the CCP came to, they just swap places from 5 to 7 on both sides. And then it's the collect their money, so they collect $7. And we're going to go on to the Russia turn. So no income increase on the die roll because we're at full income now. I did, again, I corrected it to 47 instead of 45 for Mongolia. And let's do tech rolls. So I've got my tech rolls lined up. Mechs, artillery, factories, jets, and rockets. It's a 6 failure, 5 failure, 2 failure, 11 make it, and 6 failure. So I get only one, and it's probably the, well, it's good to get that moving, but not so great. All right, then my purchases. So I've got $43 for my fire sale. I'm going to spend 23 on militia, and then 8 on infantry, and, 8 times 2 is 16 on infantry, and 4 on airborne. So 23 plus 20 is all 43 spent. I am going to have a couple of combat moves. So I can only have one attack on a Russian land zone, but I can raid them. So this one will go 1, 2, 3, and raid up here, and then in here we'll raid with these other two. See what we can do. The one land zone I'm going to attack is here in Lubelski, or is that what it is? Yeah, Lubelski. So I got one cav going 1, 2. I've got an airborne coming off the air transport going 1, 2, 3. And I will bring at least the tactical bomber. 1, 2, 3. You can move 2 more. I'll bring 1 fighter as well. A little overkill, but I can only go one place, so. That is only one Soviet occupied, or not Soviet, one land zone. Now I can make one other attack, and so I'm going to take this cavalry, and he's going to go 1, 2, and he's going to attack here. And what this is going to do is probably, I'm hoping to just go one round. And actually, I think I can go and go 1 into Kobdo and then 2 into here, so that way I can retreat into Kobdo. He is attacking at a 2, and he's defending at 4, so as long as he doesn't get a hit, I can retreat. But what it does is it activates all 3 warlords, and they will flip. All 3 of them will hopefully roll for either KMT or CCP. These rolls down here are so low. They're only, you know, at a 4 with $2. And I guess if I get this one, then it could be at a 6 with $3. But it's hard to get 2, so we're just going to try, see what we can do, see if we can make them ours. So that is the only, or those are the only attacks I have. All right, so let's roll some dice. So first off, I've got a tactical bomber at 7 and a fighter at 6 over here. Hopefully this is just over really quick. Looking for two hits. Oops. The blue is the 7. That is one hit. And then I've got two. There's no river or anything. Nope, so I've got two threes here for the airborne and the cav, and we got one hit. So we got our two hits that we need. He's got a roll back at a one in blue and a two, sorry, one in black and a two in blue. Those are both misses. Okay, so cavalry is dead. The fighter and tac bomber are going to go 4-5 and land in Rokursk. This is dead. This is mine. Oh gosh, why does it keep doing that? Okay. And then the last attack over here. So we'll roll my two and then two fours. So he might just be dead. There we go. So one at two in red and two at four in black. Wow, there's a lag. I got a hit and he missed both. I, as much as I would love to press this, I think I probably want to preserve. A two versus a four is probably not the best way to do it. What if I could take it? Is it worth three? Worth a cav? It's a 50-50 shot there. I'll do the 50-50 shot to make it KMT or CCP, sorry. And then I really forgot to check to see if it's I'm supposed to roll high or if I'm supposed to roll low. To try to get that to align. And so hold on just a second. I apologize where I look it up. And we're gonna look for come on. Come on. Okay, so 1 through 6 aligns with CCP and 7 through 12 with the KMT. So let's go ahead and roll. We'll start here with Sinkiang. We want 1 through 6. Whoops. That's a 5, so that goes CCP. Clone. Oops. Why? It's stuff is lagging and bugging out like crazy. Okay, so now, I think probably the most important ones. Xinjiang was important, but this one's also very important. So we'll roll here for Yunnan next. That is CCP. And we'll go ahead and roll again for Kuangtung. Another one. That's awesome. So we get all of these territories. Perfect. And that gets gone. That's gone. Makes me wish that I had bought a rail, but I thought four militia were more important. Okay, so that goes up by four income for the CCP. So CCP goes from 7 to 11. All right. That was it for combat. Did the one here, the one there. Oh no, I need to raid. So. Should be a +2 for me. So first sub on this line. Red is the attacker. That's nothing. Second sub. That is 1 damage. Next we, whoops, we'll raid in, son of a gun, raid in here, same thing. Red is the attacker. That is nothing. One more. Nothing. Wow. Doing pretty good on those defensive rolls. Should have gone the. Oh, I should have raided with that dude. I completely forgot. 1, 2. He could have hit the line up here. Oh, well. Too late. So that's just $1 off the Germans, unfortunately, which takes them to 60. And that was all my combat. So non-combat. I already moved the planes back. I will take these three infantry, move them forward. With that, I will add. Oh my gosh, why is this thing so messed up? Son of a gun, come on. This minor factory is going to rail. east into Buryatia. Actually, it'll rail all the way to Cheetah. These three infantry will step forward. These two infantry will step up. This infantry will step up. This cavalry will step up. And as my second rail, this AA will rail all the way over. Let's see. All the rest of that is okay where it's at. Actually, this guy will walk over here. This guy will walk down. This guy will walk over. The air transport had to fly to here, then fly back. So he stays up there. All this right here that was already here steps forward one along with the two cavalry. Two of these infantry will stay back. Just two there. Actually, we'll keep all three that were there back. Just the one. Oh, we also have a bunch of... No. Bunch of these. I think these were combat moves. I apologize. I should have done them a little sooner. I have to leave this rail back here intact because I railed that way. You see, he can only take. I guess he can airborne a couple places, but not much. And then I'm also going to scorch this airfield. So. That, oh my gosh, stupid thing. Oh gosh. Rewind. Sorry, you are seeing in real time what happens when you accidentally unlock the map or do something to the map, whatever I did. Now you get to sit here and watch with me for a minute. You get to see how slow my computer is. Looks like I only missed this one. Okay. Do it like this. It's the appropriate way to lock it. Okay, let me keep moving. My apologies. So, let's get to place units. Oh gosh. This thing is lagging like crazy. I have two airborne going into Leningrad. I have two militia going into Leningrad. One militia in Smolensk. One militia into southern Belarusia. Three militia into Kiev. One militia into eastern Ukraine. Two militia into Oryol Kursk. Along with five infantry. I have two militia into Transcaucasia. Two militia into North Caucasia. One militia into Taurida. militia into Stalingrad. Let's see. An infantry into Smolensk. An infantry into Moscow. An infantry into Novosibirsk. These additional seven militia are likely all going over here, but let me look. Sorry, non-combat move. This militia moves back. Two militia into Primorsky Krai. An additional one into Amur. One into Chita. One into Buryatia. Guess the infantry that was there is going to walk forward. One into Novosibirsk. No, I don't need Novosibirsk. One up here. And the last one, I will go into... Kuban. That's probably good for my income. Still at 47. I think if I hit, it shouldn't move. 47 plus the 3 for propaganda war means I collect 50 for this next turn. I put 51 minus. And that completes the rest of the Soviet turn. It's going to be over to the Japanese to see what they would like to do over on this side of the map. It looks like they probably are going to go after the U.S. I was thinking, I put so much militia and stuff down here because the way they spread out, it looks like they could try to fix their monetary problems, their income problems with money out of Russia. If they want to, they are welcome to go ahead and work at it, and I will be welcome to, or I will be open to doing the similar, fighting them for it. So, all right, I will leave it there for the Japanese. Cheers.